Can using keyboard shortcuts in Microsoft Teams with an external keyboard be a good alternative to the old wavy, mousy, pointy, clicky stuff? Let's find out. As we all know, as users of Microsoft products, there are many different ways to do things within a user interface designed by the big MS. Anyway, with Microsoft Teams, it's of no exception. Many users have found that using an external keyboard with keyboard shortcuts for Microsoft Teams on Windows helps them work more efficiently. For example, users with mobility or vision disabilities, keyboard shortcuts can be easier than using a touchscreen and are also an essential alternative to using a mouse. We'll take a look at some of these keyboard shortcuts and break down to see if they're going to save us some time or not. Now, the keyboard shortcuts in the general section tend to deal with general activities, as you would imagine. Straight off the bat, what we can do is you can press the control key and the full stop if you're in the UK, or the period key if you're in the US, and that will bring up a list of the keyboard shortcuts. Now, they're all here, and we're going to go through each one of these and show them in context. Now, here's a strange thing. Given it's meant to help save your time, pressing control and period to bring up these keyboard shortcuts is one thing, right? But if you press it again, it doesn't get rid of them. You've got to press escape to close. So that's very important. Next up, pressing control and E will take us straight to the command bar, where you can then quickly type in, for example, your presence, whether you want to be do not disturb, or select any of the commands that we spoke about in one of our other commands that could save you time videos. So for example, /DND for do not disturb. Now, that's been done. Great, fantastic. We've been set as do not disturb. Pressing control E again brings up the commands, /available. And we've got an entire video on that as well. And the presence is working much better now. The tenant has updated itself. Now, another command that will show the commands that you can use from the command line is control and the /key. That brings up a list of all the commands that you can use in the top command that can also increase and improve your productivity within Microsoft Teams. Now, we already spoke about setting your presence of availability, be right back, away, and things like that, but also what's new, for example, to show you what's new in Teams. And we've got a video detailing all these commands on the channel, so take a look. Now, as standard, you get a certain view with Microsoft Teams, but your eyesight might not be what it was, or the font might not be working out too well for you. Holding down the control key and then tapping the plus button will enlarge the text and fonts on the screen, sort of magnification mode. And then, as you can imagine, this also works in reverse, with holding the control key down and then the minus to reduce the magnification on that, right down to where it is virtually ineligible. Now, for navigation commands, these tend to do exactly what they say on the tin. It's about navigating around the user interface. Now, you do get some differences between the web app that I'm using here and with what you use on the desktop. For example, control and 1 in the desktop app will open activity, but where in the web, control, shift and 1 will open the activity feed. Again, in the desktop app, control and 2 will open chat, whereas in the web app, control, you guessed it, shift and 2 will open the chat window with your most recent contacts, and the most recent person you have spoken to will be highlighted. Control 3 in the desktop app and control shift 3 will open the Teams view and present the list of Teams on the left hand side in the Team viewer for you to select. And to open meetings in the desktop app, it's control and 4, which in the web is control shift 4. And that will then take you to the Microsoft Teams meeting side of it, and you can see what you've got going on today in your busy meetings. To open calls, again, it's control 5 and control shift 5. To open files, You can either obviously go to the icons on the left hand side, which is perfectly fine, or you can say Control Shift and 6, and that will then take you to the file section. Now with this I have found different results. Now if you're in the Teams view, you click on it, click on the main window, Control Shift 6, nothing has happened. Again, click in the mentions down here, Control Shift 6 in web, nothing is happening. Some of these keyboard shortcuts, depending on how you use them, are a little bit temperamental. So use them and need them as you see fit. In the messaging section of the shortcut keys, as you'd imagine, it deals with the messaging type side of things for Microsoft Teams. Pressing the C key takes the cursor automatically down to start a new conversation. To expand that control box or compose box, Control Shift and X will expand it up so you can get your words in. Full text as well as bold letters and highlighting. A little bit of additional highlighting as well. Anyway, that's going to be Control Shift and X, and that's the same in both the desktop and on the web app. To send, Control and Enter. To attach a file, Control and O. There we go, we've attached the collaboration kernel file. Let's move back. To start a new line, let's wait for Teams to get back together. Shift and Enter. Now there are several other keyboard shortcuts and it's evolving all the time. And it'd be really interesting for you to let me know in the comment section if the keyboard shortcuts indeed save you time when you're collaborating in Microsoft Teams, and approximately how much time it saves you by doing it this way. I've been the Collaboration Kernel. Thanks very much for watching. Like and subscribe and check back for more videos in the series.